time, the bringer of oblivion has cancelled from the mind of man that which was. Now I, a witness of the twilight of time, have returned among you to tell you of the eternal struggle between evil and good. Near the great river, there lived the people of the plain. They were ruled by Athor, a wise and just king. So great was his fame that it passed over all human boundaries and became known in the infernal regions to the dismay of the forces of evil. Athor's love of justice and the prosperity given to his people by many years of peace provoked the wrath and the hatred of the great demon, who saw in that king a proud enemy and an obstacle to the expansion on earth of his own fell kingdom. Thus it was that evil selected Crotar, king of the cold regions, and crept into his heart, offering him visions of a great empire. Crotar became jealous of the fame of Athor, and the flame of hatred swelled within him and caused him to gather a fierce army which, under his command, invaded the lands of the peaceful people of the plain. Crotar's bloodthirsty hordes rode through the night. They crossed rivers and mountains, and at the first light of dawn, their horses trampled the smiling fields of the people of Athor. Only one command did Crotar give to his cohorts: death. With that cry, his men and his beasts were loosed upon the gentle people of the plain. Their weapons cried out for blood and drank that of the innocent. In one tragic dawn, an entire people was annihilated. There were feasts and there was laughter in the halls of the great demon that day. One small ray of light was set after that terrible carnage. King Athor's last-born son was saved by his old nurse, who found shelter in the mount. Athor, his family, and his people were slaughtered by the blind fury that boiled in Crotar's soul. But the child who was saved from the storm grew until he was tall and proud and strong, a man who dared to challenge the elements. Around him grouped the pitiful remnant of his people. From among them, he chose the maiden Lene as his wife and set out with them to find a land where they could live in peace. His name was Sangraal of the Sword of Fire. After fighting, suffering, starving, and fearing, they were near the end of their strength. The happy land where they could finally live, the land that Sangraal had promised them, was it just an empty illusion? For days without end, they had been marching beneath a cruel, scorching sun. Their water bags were dry. Several horses had died. Along the road, they had buried old people and children. Their thirst was as great as their dejection.
Fill your water bags and mount up. Move. You won't find me marching so soon again. I say we stay on this land. At least there's water, Sangraal. I'll never see the land that you promised to us.
Everything I told you will happen, Das. You've got to have patience. I'll find us fertile land, good for tilling and hunting, and where life will be good to us, where you can raise your children in peace. It's nearer than anybody thinks. I won't disappoint you.
Killed, Sangraal. What kind of men are they who did this? It can only be the work of a bloodthirsty and evil race.
Land belongs to anyone who can cultivate it. Those are simply sticks in the ground. We haven't come this far to be turned back by a handful of firewood and some old bones. Once again, I tell you to have faith in me. The same gods that brought us here will go on protecting us.
Of evil can produce only more evil, just as good can generate only more good. The faith of the just cannot be bent. Sangraal brought his people to the land where he hoped they could live in peace, even though in his soul he knew he must fight against the ever-present demon of evil.
Gods, I tell you, this will be the land of our future and our children.
My husband, you will be a wise and just king, and your name will be honored everywhere.
Silence! I said be silent. There's a battle going on down there. Get the women hidden. Old men and boys, be ready to defend them. Warriors, follow me.
Oh! the goddess on you!
Where's your village?
Why are you asking me?
Don't be afraid. We come in peace. We're only looking for land in these parts.
I am not afraid of you. You saved our lives. I hope you'll allow us the chance to express our great thanks. Voria will be glad to guide you. I must get there first to tell my father about your arrival. He will do us a great honor.
I accept gladly. Who is she?
Aki, the daughter of our chieftain.
I bid you welcome among us. My name is Belem, and I am chief of this village. My daughter Aki has told me how you defended our people so bravely, and that you are looking for land to live on. If you wish, you are welcome to settle here.
Your offer is very generous, Belem.
I know I speak for all of us in asking you to unite your people with ours. We will respect you and all who come with you. And we will call you Sangraal of the Sword of Fire.
Because I fought your enemies on your land?
Yes. Because today you saved us from an attack, and I know you will save us from the next one.
What?
They are Naluk's men, servants and priests. Do you know his name?
Not sure. But the sound is ill-omened.
Ill-omened? Naluk is more than that. He is powerful and able to carry out his evil with the help of Rani, the goddess of fire he worships. Stay with us, Sangraal, and defend us.
Accept your offer, Bella. Sangraal's people, as of this day, have been joined in brotherhood to you and your people, equals among equals. And I take an oath that no one, god or mortal alike, will go unpunished for wrong or evil acts. And this oath I maintain in faith.
May Rani see fit to increase your power.
Now, faithful priests of Rani.
Yes, Lord.
Over there.
Come.
Pour your immense power on my soul and expand my kingdom so that I may serve you better and glorify your name.
The goddess of wrath and destruction hears you, Naluk.
Goddess of fire, now that the sacrifice has been completed, make yourself visible to our eyes.
Come, Naluk. In the kingdom of the dead, I listened to your prayers and sated my hunger on your offering.
I kneel at your feet in the power of your protection.
I shall not protect you much further, Naluk. My heart is raging with hatred, and my blood screams for vengeance.
How has your servant offended you, my goddess?
You allowed a miserable wretch to murder some of my priests.
His name is Sangraal. He has crossed your borders and is now living in my kingdom.
A stranger? That's not possible.
You doubt my sacred oath, then, miserable creature? Then tell me who did commit this sacrilege, and why isn't this pig being punished yet? My patience has a limit, Naluk. Avenge me or you will be punished.
You won't repent that you trusted me. Naluk's word for it. Rani, I am your servant and your slave. I will take vengeance for you. I swear it.
Remember what you have just sworn, Naluk. Be assured that I will not forget it.
Rani! Goddess of fire and death! Hear me! Rani, hear my words. I swear to you on these sacred flames. By goddess, you shall enjoy your revenge. Find peace when this fire starts to leap and to play over Sangraal's body. Oh!
Naluk is about to attack. He's not far away.
Tara! You command the village now. I'll take some men. Try to surprise Naluk. Molly, bring me my horse. Horse, Dandy, Toriel, come with me.
May the gods protect you, Sangraal.
If they don't, my sword will.
He loves you very much, doesn't he? I saw the way he was looking at you before he left.
Yes, I know. But I saw how you were looking at him, too.
Oh, look. Those are Naluk's soldiers. They're going around the hill to attack the village from the other side. Let's try to cut them off. Hurry, go!
The man you have dared to defy. I am Naluk, your master. Sangraal, your sun is sinking below the horizon. You'll be burned alive on the sacred flames. But first, Naluk wants you to watch what happens to his enemies.
The gods will punish you for this, Naluk.
The gods, you say, Sangraal? You ask them to save your village if they can. But they're powerless.
Hey,
you and your house.
Ronnie's anger tonight, you filthy swine! Someone kill the guards and let Sangraal get away! I want that man! This way! Yeah.
You two, down there. Might have crossed the river. Can't have just disappeared. Where is he? Come on!
Well, Gallus, did you find him?
No, Lord, he's disappeared. The guards are protecting him.
Sangraal!
Lady, you come out now, yes? They have all gone away. Danger no more.
Who are you?
My name is Liu Tuan. What's yours?
Aki.
Aki is beautiful. Sound is like music, yes?
You have strange eyes. I've never seen a face like yours before. Which village are you from?
Ah, this strange face come from far off. My father, he brought me here. From the land where the sun is born every day. No broken bones?
You must have seen us below.
Huh? Twancy, very good. Strange eyes, but very sharp. Something you need?
Water and some food, too. Sangraal is very weak.
Ah, Twan has everything. Even oil that will heal wound. Let us see sick man now.
I hope you can help him.
I can.
Aki, what happened to our village?
You are better. You are not completely better, though. Rest some more.
Can't rest. I've got to find Lenny. Help her. I can't abandon her.
There's nothing we can do for anyone in the village, Sangraal.
Find you again. You know the truth, I say. I'll find you again, and we'll be happy, you and I.
Sangraal, the past can never return again. You must realize your wife is dead now. You must start thinking about the future.
I couldn't protect her when they took her life away, so I will give it back to her. By the gods, I swear it as a sacred oath.
But you're swearing to bring the dead back to life. No one on earth can do that.
Maybe there is one person who could help you.
Who are you talking about?
Rudak, a wise man who lives in the Black Mountains. If anyone can bring the dead back to life, he can.
Is his power that great?
I don't know. You could only get the answer from Rudak in person.
Take me to where he is.
It is hard to reach his house, a most difficult thing. But Tuan know that land. He know paths that no one has ever taken yet. But that is Black Mountain. That is some trouble, too.
Try not to worry about it. I go at dawn.
Sangraal, think what you're saying. You're just throwing your life away. No one can call the dead back, not even Rudak.
You stay here. I leave in the morning. Those are your orders.
Yes, only I'm not going to follow them. I'm coming with you.
some good advice. Never look too far back, Sangraal. Or it can be very dangerous. Very long and difficult. We should perhaps walk for a while.
You're right, Swan. I wasn't thinking about the horses.
Did you notice something, Sangraal?
Not one thing. What's there to notice?
Ah, then you not notice the same thing as Swan. Ancient proverbs say, two eyes on one woman is one too many.
Sangraal's faith is unshakable. His companions have shared the danger and the toil with him. All three are united in a single hope, to bring about the dream that Sangraal carries in his heart, to give life back to Lene, and to take vengeance on the men who slew her. But their road is still long. Many tests and many dangers await them yet.
I think so.
Careful. Look up there. There's something happening. See some torches down a little further. Let's get a couple. Keep your eyes open, both of you.
Look. Do you know what this must mean? Torch flicker. It means another entrance to cave. Air coming in.
I hope you're right, Tuan. It's a death trap otherwise. Be careful. There's a steep drop here.
Oh, Sangraal, I'm afraid.
It'll be all right. Just move slowly. Give me your hand. That's it. Come on now. Come over this way. Easy now.
Go slow.
Take it easy. In more caves, more tunnels.
Like that. What are these horrible things?
I don't know, but I think we'll be seeing more of them.
Tuan thinks so, too. But now Tuan understands the great mystery. They not see anything. They blind.
Of course, they had no eyes. But how did they find us?
You listen. I explain as we walk.
Well, Tuan?
They did not see us. They came to the heat of our torches and the sound of our movements.
I hope that's not true. We'll never find a way out of here if we have to put out our torches and try to move without making a sound.
They come from over there, too.
Go on, wave your torch back and forth. But throw it against the wall when I do.
No!
Just hope the
outside.
He must have heard that. Take care of Aki. Hurry! There'll be more of them any minute. Listen! You hear water flowing.
But he got out and is now very near his goal. I have shown my favors to an idiot, poor and helpless.
I'll fail no more, Rani. I promise you solemnly. I beg you, grant one more chance. These slowly shall be taken and broken apart. By your sacred name, he shall die a thousand deaths. I swear this, goddess.
My curse be on your puny realm should you fail this time. I shall crush you beneath my heels. You'll ride in torment forever. You hear, Naluk?
Rani! Rani! I swear that Sangraal will roast on your sacred flame before sunset! Rani, hear me! Goddess, I swear it. Trust me one last time, Rani!
Look, that is where the wise man lives. You must climb to the top. If you are worthy, he will speak to you.
He will speak to me.
You must let me go with you, Sangraal.
But I have to ask Rudak. Only he must hear. Listen to me, Tuan. Nothing must happen to her. Protect her.
I will, Sangraal, with my life.
You'd better camp here. Wait for my return.
May the gods smile on you, my friend.
I feel the sorrow in your heart that has led you to me.
Where are you, Rudak? I can't see you. Make yourself visible to me. And hear what I ask you.
If your faith is as great as your pain, and if you ask for justice rather than vengeance, you shall see me soon. I have been waiting for you.
You? You, I was coming?
those who suffer look for peace sooner or later.
And can you give it to me?
I can do no more than show the trail that leads there. The past is how your torture and your woe are born. Your future and your peace you must win for yourself.
Rudak, I was told that you have the power to take the dead and give them their life back. Now I ask you to give her life to Lenny and punish those evil men who worship death.
No one, my son, has the power to call a soul back from the kingdom of the dead. You can no more ask that than you can ask the river to change its course.
But how can I see her again? Rudak, I must.
She is beyond your call in the undying kingdom. You must destroy evil and find peace.
I must destroy the forces of evil. There are too many, too powerful. No one alone.
You are not alone, Sangraal. If you are worthy, you will meet the forces of good that live within you. They will guide your arm and your thoughts. But first, you must go to the forest of Aranda.
All right. Where is it?
Follow the sun for 3 days, and you will come to its borders. Stay on the path of the sun. Walk into the forest, and you will find a cavern that guards a great secret. The Ark of the Templars, the great champions of justice. If you are able to open it, listen to their voices. Now go. I can spend no more time here, and this body is about to dissolve. Fight and win your battle for peace, Sangraal. My blessing goes with you. Fight, Sangraal. Go now. Follow the path of the sun.
Rudak. Rudak. Don't forget.
I will not forget my promise, Sangraal. Now follow the path of the sun.
Here we are. This is edge of forest of Aranda. Not good place. Mostly evil around. We go on with road of sun. Sun go that way.
Come. Rudak sent to look for a cavern. It may hold the answer for us. We've got to hurry. Find the cavern in this labyrinth. Even the trees seem to be closing in on us.
Forest jealous of secret. You will have to steal it.
Why did you stop, Sangraal?
I don't like this. Listen.
What am I supposed to be listening to? I don't hear a thing.
No animals, no birds. Not good sign, Aki. Birds were singing before. Now only silence.
We'd better move, though. Must find that cavern. Come on, hurry.
Footprint of Sangraal. But he not break branch. Animal do this.
What kind of animal?
Why not know this? You find out soon enough.
Sangraal come this way. What is here? Stop! Look. Down there.
Sangraal's sword.
He fall in there, then someone take him away. There are many footprints made here where he fell. But then they disappear like magic. He go up in the air.
Tuan, that's impossible. They can't fly.
Who take Sangraal? Not walk on ground. Walk treetops. Afterwards, Tuan climb and look. We find Sangraal, no worry. Now I get his sword. He will want it. We must find him.
We will.
Yes, I see which way they went. Now I can see the path they use.
Path? How can they walk between the trees?
They grab hold of branches. They swing through air, not touch ground.
What kind of beings are they?
One does not know. What seems like a little bit man and a little bit monkey. Come, we go. Message with noise of hollow log.
What are they saying, though?
I do not understand. But still, we hurry.
Now look! I heard the drums from the forest.
Well?
They send great news. They say they have captured Sangraal.
This time, Sangraal has no hope of escaping. Tell them to cut him to ribbons. Tell them, go! You.
Yes, Lord.
Listen. Take a few men and bring me Sangraal's body. We'll burn his remains for Rani's glory.
Yes, my Lord.
Hurry!
up! Hold the prop up, Sam.
Tell me tomorrow.
Let's get out of this forest.
I think now we should look for a cavern.
I'll do it alone. Wait for me outside the forest.
I've been waiting for you for such a long time, for long, endless nights. Look at me. I am yours. Don't be afraid. Come close to me. I will give you joy and rest. Come to me. Caress my body. Come, Sangraal. Lose yourself in happiness. Come here to me. I will give you bliss. I will slake your thirst. Come, Sangraal. I will inflame your desire. Come. Lie with me. Let your eyes delight in my grief.
Rudak! Can you answer? Whose are these voices?
Rudak, help me! Release me from this temptation!
Here I am, Sangraal.
I call you in need. Rudak, help me. Rudak! Rudak! Your face!
Now, Sangraal, come closer to the ark. If your strength is sustained by faith, open it.
You will be invincible. Its powers are infinite, like the stars in the sky.
If your faith is strong enough, you will defeat evil with it.
come on.
Get out of here, Wyatt.
Let go of me.
Stop it.
Get it.
Let me go.
Here I am, Lord. I killed the man who was in Sangraal.
No.
And I brought you Aki, his companion.
I want Sangraal. Only Sangraal.
He will be in your power soon. I set a trap for him that will put him right in your hands. I left traces of this girl along the path that leads to this cavern.
Tie her up, Gallus, and flay her.
Up with you.
Whip her till the blood flows.
Let go of me. Let go. May the gods curse you, Nalu.
You'll be begging for mercy soon, slut.
Here in my power, and my goddess will be avenged.
You'll never take him. His strength is greater than yours.
And Ronnie's is greater than his. Whip her! Now my trap is baited. The mouse will run right into it.
Yes, Lord.
I've changed your orders. Take a few men. Capture and bring him in. Carry out my orders. Or the one to die will be you.
Yes, at once. Side of the river. You two stay here with me. Sangraal comes down that path. We all attack together. On my signal. Get ready! Nobody's heard.
Tell me before I kill you. Where's the path to the cavern?
The path! After the bridge. Follow the pathway east. Don't kill me, Sangraal. Don't kill me.
And your master will soon be with you.
Of the flames. Essen, where are my men?
Doing your bidding, my lord. Gallus will return soon.
Why aren't they here now? Why are they taking such a long time coming back?
It's 2 hours each way. I'm sure they'll be here within a short time, Lord.
Gallup must not fail. He cannot. I want Sangraal!
Here I am, Naluk.
Kill him!
No, you can't!
Kill that man now!
And I challenge you in front of your throne. Show me your power and show it to your people. But make peace with your goddess first, because you are going to die.
I accept your challenge. We will fight according to the customs of my people. I bring you death, Sangraal. To kill at last! What are you waiting for? Kill him! Run him through! I gave you an order! I gave you an order!
For you with the fire.
Come back here. How do you do that?
Get out of here. No time to lose.
You will go nowhere, you two. Your road finishes here.
We will go, Rani. Neither you nor all your demons can stop us.
Your words are hollow. Do you think your puny weapon can bring danger to the goddess of fire? I can destroy it with a thought.
I'm not afraid of you.
You can challenge me.
You cannot destroy this. Those who entrusted it to me have greater power than both of us. You have no power against these arrows.
Forces of evil have given way to the strength of the faith that Sangraal bears within him. His quest for justice has been fulfilled, and love has crowned his life. He has found out that good can be stronger than evil. Now it is up to you to give battle and win.